Okay, I kind of want to take a picture of this place. Yeah, there we go. Some fire plants down here. Wait, is my microphone on? Yes, okay. Jeez, don't scare me like that. Okay, so this is another new boss that we are... Ooh, is this hurt? No, yes. Yes, it does. I'm gonna heal up here quick. Okay, so we've got a new... I think this is the crab boss. Okay, well... excuse me, sir. Okay. What the fuck? She just instantly whacked my ass. He didn't kill me, I don't think. An armored crab lord that has survived for countless eons and surpassed almost all other... Yeah. The twin molten horns located high up on its body are pyro-aligned organs that can unleash more vicious elemental attacks and grant it even stronger defensive capabilities. When the armored crab lord unleashes certain attacks, its twin molten horns are closer to the ground. This provides for a great opportunity to use elemental reactions to remove the pyro element within. So, water, electro, maybe? I don't know. How much damage did he do? Enough. Watch out, he's jumping sideways. Oh, he's got the... he's got a pyro effect on him right now. Okay, he's on his ass. Holy shit, he just took some damage. And he's dead. Okay. He's also quite... he hits quite hard. I will take his new items. Let's see, what do we get now? Emperor's Resolution. Okay, and that's another stage done in our event. That's the final stage, actually. Defeat him and then also destroy the Emperor of Fire and Iron Twins' Molten Horns one time. I didn't know that, but we did it on accident, so I'll take it. Nice, nice. More rewards. Fill me up. Damn it. Excuse me? What? I mean, if you want to. Okay, battle pass. We did something. This BP period. Defeat the Emperor of Fire and Iron during the Relic Records creation of the Hydro Nation event. Some money out of it. Okay. Take me all the way back out. Oh man, if they're gonna have like underwater caves and stuff, who knows how well hidden shit could be. Also, my ear itches. Where am I? Okay, that way we need to go to find... I need to find the... there it is. It's over that way. I need to get myself that final statue so that I can have the full map unlocked, or visible at the very least. Fucker flew away super slowly and I still missed. Hello. Deal with you guys first. Okay, you're dead. There's still one guy over on the bitch. What the fuck? Okay. I'm gonna try to head straight to... oh, it's this way. What are you guys doing? Is this your ship? No, this just looks like a Fontanian ship. Now, they kept talking about the Fontaine fleet, but... I guess perhaps a fleet doesn't have to be militaristic. Usually when you think of a fleet, you think of, like, you know, warships and stuff. But none of these look combat ready. I'd say so far the Liyue ships are more combat ready than these. But these, they seem to have some, like, paddle wheels to them that are controlled by machine. What is that? I want it. Flat crest, full What the fuck? Son of a bitch, dude. Oh my god, that was horrible. I just sneezed and it caught me off guard and stuff came spraying out of every orifice. God damn it. Okay. Now, I don't need to hear Rika Bean moaning noises. Hold on, there's some crabs over here I want to go kill. Wait, why? Why is my... Wait, why is everything on, like, super cool down here? Hello? Oh, it's... It's because I had the fucking thing selected. Okay, that must be another stage done in this. Let's see, stage two. Some. Defeat five of those aberrants, I guess. The crabs, that's what they're called for me. We have to kill the clockwork mechas. We've killed three of five, and we also need to defeat seven normal opponents in Fontaine's underwater zones. When did I kill three underwater creatures? When did that happen? Hello? I don't remember doing that. And we're getting some new weapon materials, I guess. I'll take some more primigems. I'm not going to complain about that. We got a new chunk. How can you have a chunk of a liquid substance? You little fucking shit. Son of a bitch. If I didn't have to get stuck in that barrel, I would have gotten the bitch. It's a challenge there. I'll worry about that later. Let's continue on with our objective. I understand the assignment, and I will complete it, but I am now getting distracted by these flowers, so hold on. Oh, it's not too far away. We're almost there. Okay, I see some new creature in front of us. Looks like a big crab. It's all watery sounding here and everything. It's a fire crab. That's not good. It's shooting out fire. I haven't seen very many hillitrolls yet, surprisingly. It's been mostly men. Where are you going, you bitch? The water here is hot! Paimon's going to get cooked. You can fly, you little shit. Oh, this must be a puzzle thing. I'll figure this out later. Why is the... Okay, the water here is hot. There's some bubbly water, including that fiery crab zone. Does that mean we border Natland, then? Because if Natland's supposed to be the Pyra region and possibly has a volcano, then you would assume that there'd be, like, acidic pools of hot springs and stuff like that everywhere, which would make total sense because the biome is close to a volcano, which would be really cool if that's how that works. Environmental factories. When under the effects of Pyro, it can unleash fiercer elemental attacks and possess even stronger defensive capabilities. If you use elemental reactions to remove its elemental shield, things should be easier to handle. Thankfully, I have characters that can easily do that. I see more new stuff. Like, what's that whirlwind thing there? It looks like the rift weapon from the rift gun or whatever from Ratchet and Clank up your arsenal. Oh, there's a ley line. Hello. Wow, I matched those notes on accident. That's awesome. Wow, look at this. This is pretty. Okay, and here we have a whole mountainous area, island. So this is all of Fontaine right now. It kind of reminds me a little bit almost of Inazuma, in the sense that it's... Notice how the water is also lighter and not darker like everywhere else. In that it's kind of... Well, shit. Actually, surprisingly, it looks like some of the islands in Inazuma are smaller than the islands here. By quite a bit, actually. Well, I was going to say that it reminds me of Inazuma in that it's like islands surrounded by water, except the islands are more solid rather than being little bits and pieces. And also you can swim underwater, so... There's that. I would not want to do that in Inazuma's region. An ocean? I ain't swimming in no ocean. You better not add that shit to the game. Okay. So... what do I do? Well, now that we've opened the map, I guess we will continue and do our event stuff. Got an achievement! For opening all of the bullshit. Yep, light up the maps. Okay, let's see what our event has left for us to do. Okay, we have to kill these guys. Go to challenge, let's see. Okay, it's got me going south. This kind of reminds me of, not necessarily the terrain, well, like the mountain reminds me of Skellige from The Witcher 3. Because like Skellige has this mountain range on it, but it's like in the game it's a lot smaller than it's really supposed to be. So you just see this huge mountain, but then it's really tiny when you walk up next to it. Okay, they're supposed to be right here. Somewhere. Hello? Up there. Okay. Whoop! Oh, it looks like we got a new one. And they're working. Two new ones. Oh, fuck. I killed that one. These ones roll around. Okay, they're dead. I don't know what that said. It said something about a bounty. Okay, this thing. She created complement energy defects. Plenish the power of nearby disabled clockwork mecha that shares a similar energy source. After their energy is annihilated by an attack charged with the opposite signature, it will induce an overload state. Okay, and then we have the rolling thing. Okay, there's a lot of this two different energy thing, and I don't know what that means. Did it ever tell me about that? It doesn't seem to be in this spot, but... Okay, now it's telling me to go probably to a beach somewhere. Oh, it's telling me to go in the water. It's in the water... Well, I guess we have to kill things in the water, too, so let's fast travel back here. Oh, wait, there's a Wave Rider thing there. Oh, right, I couldn't see it because the map wasn't opened up. Okay. Well, I will go select that quick. And I don't know what I'm looking at, but I see an inverted vortex. Is that an enemy, or is that like a puzzle? There's a fishing spot! Well, let me see what this is first. It's not an enemy. Hello? Well, I'm in it. What do I do now? What's this thing? Oh! It's the block! What the fuck? Energy blocks can be naturally occurring or artificially created. And they are separated into the P blocks and O blocks.
After collecting an energy block, your next normal charge or plunging attack will, upon hit, release the energy stored within them. So that's how I get the energy sources. This will come in handy when adventuring in a place like Fontaine. With the aid of these energy blocks, characters can unleash P or O energies even while underwater. Most characters from Fontaine have an And thus can use their attacks to trigger energies corresponding to their attribute underwater without the use of P blocks. So I guess Fontaine characters just get special benefits. Well, this clearly made a platform appear, which it then does what? What? This disturbance attracts an uninvited guest. A robot dog. What? With a gun in its face, of course. Get rid of you. Ow, you fucker. Ow. Got another block. Oh, I see, because now it's blue, so if I attack it with the yellow colored one. So we've got another new entry. Just hold on. I'm trying to not die. Dude! I'm out of juice. And now I got a chest. Okay. 10 primigems, damn. And that thing disappeared. So I guess it's like a little combat challenge. So we got a specialist mech, which basically just looks like a melee one with a sword. Makes sense. Recon log mech with a fucking gun in its face. I guess it's supposed to be a camera since it's a recon drone, basically. Looks like most of these descriptions say the same thing. That you use the opposite type of energy to attack it. And they're mutual annihilation. Wait, hold on. These are the properties found in the life forms earth, air, and watery veins of Fontaine. The collision between energies of different properties causes annihilation and the production of greater energies. It is this principle that powers many clockwork mecha. Of course, the power supply of these mecha is unstable, resulting in P or O aligned energy states. Attacks with the opposite alignment can be used to overload and disable their power supplies. Well, thank you for telling me that after I fought multiple of these enemies. Okay. Now, fishing spot? Absolutely. I am going to fish here. Oh, wait, I might not have the right bait. Yeah, never mind. We won't fish here right now. We'll come back later. I don't have the bait. I'll have to see what we need to craft that stuff. Balls, 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 balls. Wait a minute, there's a fucker standing out here. What the hell are you doing out here, you prick? Get out of here. Wait, is there a structure underwater? It's like that scene from Final Fantasy X. Where the whole city built of Machina was built over the river and then collapsed into it. Somewhere here. I don't know how deep this water is, and I don't like that I can't see under it, but I see a viewpoint down there. What is it telling me? I must have done something. Oh, the clockwork mechas. Okay. No. Bam! Wow! Look at this! Holy shit. It's Subnautica. Okay, so I get to do something here, right? So I can attack, I guess. see some over here. How does this work? Okay, so it's pretty basic. I guess they couldn't go through the process of, you know, modeling every character in the game's underwater attack animation, so they just decided to add something like the Wave Rider. But they don't seem to do anything themselves, do they? Let me see. The enemies don't seem to do anything, at least not yet. Unless I'm genuinely slaughtering a peaceful Oh, dude, look. Okay, so far I don't like how big that creature is. So far they seem to have done pretty well on the underwater controls. Dude, what the fuck? Look at this. Is a harvestable thing? Oh, this is for one of my whatchamacallits. I will do that after I'm done killing more of these shits. Can I take screenshots down here, please? Oh, yes, I can. Okay. I'm totally taking a screenshot and posting it on the community. And then people will be like, dude! When are you uploading it? And then 10 years later, I'll upload it. What is this stuff? Stuff I can't seem to break. What? Hold on, I might need... Okay, that just heals me. How does one break these? Oh, here we go, I can aim. No? No, that... Okay, there must be something else I have to do for this. Wait, what is this? Absorb the abilities of the Xenochromatic... Gee. I literally just killed it. Creates a heavily armored shield capable of releasing shockwaves that can shatter stones. Holding it down will continuously expand the shield, and when you release the skill, it will release a shockwave in the direction you're aiming. So, E. Oops. I'm holding it down, but... Condensed crystal. Oh no, that does not say condensed. Condescence crystal, I guess. Have to be broken with my... Yep. What are these? Oh, and these are those flower things that, like, pop up and explode. Wow. Okay. I did stop getting distracted. We gotta do... I gotta keep focused here. Screenshot really bad though. It looks like it's not affected by day or night. Looks like it's its own time zone when you're underwater to keep the visuals as consistent as possible. Well, it says I'm in the area with them. I guess I already killed them then, right? What is that thing? Thank God we can hold our breath forever. Or I guess we can breathe, I suppose. Oh, there's some right there. So I wonder what happens if I use my special on these guys. Oh, it hurts. Okay, I think we killed enough of them. The current bounty quest is complete. Okay, that's what it's telling me. It's this stuff. Okay, that's stage 2 completed. Is this what's next to us here? No. Well, there is definitely something over here, though, that it wants me to collect. They're an algae. I've completed a quest. Shit, you have to do that really close. Oh, these must be underwater specific things. Seem to be harvestable. Oh, there's more stuff down here. Now that thing looks like it's gonna shoot me. Why did another one spawn? Oh, they shoot. Okay, so movement, I guess, is how you do combat here. Investigate. What is this thing? It's like a seal, and it's angry. It's dead and dropped a goo piece. Okay, this is for combat, I guess. Underwater patrol mech. Okay, yeah, it's basically the same thing. You've seen what it does, it shoots. Now we just gotta find some of these flowers. I'm curious to see if I can actually aim at these. Yeah, they just explode, okay. Let's see, where is... Okay, the book is to the north. Oh, for Christ's sake. That is, I hate that so much. What is this thing? Wait, does aiming do more damage? No. I guess you can just tap the E key for a like an AoE. Get out of here. Again. Enter. Well, I don't know what's happened. Let me out. What the fuck? Ugh. Now what? Oh, I see. It was a chest that's blocked off, and that's how you get into it. Oh, I lost my E from that thing. Oh, there's one right there. It looks like you get to keep it, probably, I guess, for as long as you stay underwater. Oh, there's still that, like, the sewer area in the city I didn't check out. This music. Man, imagine... Yeah, okay, I can definitely see now why Fontaine was such a quote-unquote small chunk of land that they added new territory, because it's got all this underwater shit. Where is that? Okay, straight ahead. It's a collection zone. No, you're leaving me alone, you manta ray shits. Oh, they're these things. We've gotten a few of these. Was this the video where I fought the boss? It was, wasn't it? Shit, I want the thumbnail to be... ocean. Okay, so we still need to collect... Okay, this must be surface stuff here, and then this is water stuff. What's the final thing we need to do here? Defeat 2 Breacher Primuses? Defeat 2 Tainted Hydro Phantasms? Defeat a total of 5 Breacher... Okay, what? This... I don't know what these are. We haven't seen these yet. The music is going to give me a boner. Oh, the music. Please. All right, let me see here. We got a thing down there, and there's a... Well, I don't see a book anywhere else, so... And this book is for collecting stuff. So I don't know where you fight those other creatures at. Because at least the book's not showing me. Okay. We're leaving the water temporarily. There's a world quest down there. I see some Aramites. Oh no. Shit, I'm gonna have to help those guys out at some point. Are they bullying one of the little things? Don't do that. These things. Oh, and one of the things I need is actually nearby. Hello? Oh, there you are. What are you? What are you? I don't know. I will fight you and then read the tutorial on how to kill you. A little one and a big one. Kill the little one. Foreign synapse. Rift core. Large Shatterstone Breacher. Strange life form that shares nothing in common with any other land-dwelling creature. In battle, it will enter a stress state and unleash a fearsome stonefall attack while under the protection of a Geo shield. If the shield is broken during this period, it will cause the life form to fall into a paralyzed state. Attacks imbued with O or P can also efficiently pierce defenses. Then there's the little one. It says Geo shield, but I don't see them. They weren't colored Geo color, were they? Ow. Prick. Okay, now we have to head to the opposite side of this plate. I see plate stuff to mine. Me want to mine it. What the hell? Oh, this is stuff I'm gonna need to do this for. I want to go back in the water, damn it. Well, we're almost done with the extra challenges, and then the event thing's finished. Is this a new tree? It's yellow. No, it's just a cypress. It's those hydro things. Those are enemies? It's literally the things from the event. Except they look a little bit different. Hello? Oh. I guess they're passive until you start kicking their ass. I didn't get a tutorial at all on these guys. There you go, the event is finished. I'm on top of things for right now. Okay, well I need to go and talk to the fishing person to see if I can get, because I think I need to buy the recipe for the bait. That way I can actually start crafting the bait, which will probably be crafted out of the flowers and stuff from here. I would make that assumption. I dare do this right now. Oh, fuck it, I might as well. Grab the particles. So this is basically this place's version of that Inazuma thing. I like that the particles are blue. This reminds me of the dragon spine challenges.
Okay.
Where are you taking me? Oh, shit. Up, I guess. What the hell? There's more? That's just a person. Why is there just a person here? Okay, but what is this thing? That's what I actually came down here to check out. It's nothing. Oh, it's got the energy stuff in it. It's got the blue and yellow, or the blue and like whitish brown energy stuff. The P and O energy. And then, of course, there's just a boar here.
Yeah.
Hello. In the city. Where's this underwater city? Oh, I guess the village. I mean, the city's the big place. Why there's some of this energy just floating around. It's gotta be used for something, right? What? Excuse me, I pressed F. Got it. Is there something underwater here I have to use it on? No. It's more of this stuff. Oh, I don't have a breaky thing. What am I hearing? Oh, a sealy. An underwater sealy. Oh, that shit's gonna blend right in with this place. I'm getting so distracted from what I should be doing right now. Actually, I don't know what I should be doing. I don't really have a goal in mind. Where the hell are you taking me? Ah, right here. There's another fishing spot over there. Oh, that's what I was doing. I was gonna head over to the fishing man. Or woman. highly doubt that I can fish at that place. Oh, there's another... What? There's another thing over here. Wait, I wonder if this is what I have to use that for. A storage box. A super safe storage box that absolutely cannot be opened in any way. That is, unless someone manages to figure out if the energy it's emitting is O or P and uses an attack charge with the opposite alignment to strike, overload, and unlock it. Well, shit, gee. It'd be a shame if that were to happen. It'd be a shame if there was just some energy there. It's also the white or orange kind, I guess. And this is the blue energy. Broken money. 15,000 money. Okay, I think I will go. I'm gonna stop this episode here because I need to pee. And then we'll go try to find the fishing guy after this. Which he's up? Yeah, he's way over there. I'll see if I can swim up that way and grab a fast travel point. Make it easier to get to.